I'm going to be calling you a radical. I've been wanting to get this since Weber State announced this a few years ago. This is so criminal and so... Well, that's the state of Utah right now anymore. What is the matter with those people? So, look, I'm old enough to remember this spot, my spot, this hallowed sacred spot right here before the nuclear energy crime center at GE formed with Utah Construction, and the state of Utah took all this and built the Purple Palace. Remember when we used to have March Madness games here? Not anymore. We don't have anything. Most underutilized building in the world. Concerts? Don't even have. We used to have grand. Why? Because Weber State's run by corrupt. Weber State's Board of Regents, Weber State's hierarchy is corrupt as hell. Now, I like Brad Morris. He's trying. Now, this is important. So under eminent domain, they took all this, right? So the Standard Exaggerator, which could be the worst paper in the United States, actually wrote a decent piece. And when the Glassman family had it, it was one of the best newspapers in the United States for decades. So let me show you this. So they took all this for eminent domain. And so some people lived right there 45 years ago. Their house was right there. So the Standard did a piece about it. This is so corrupt. It's our. So Weber State is actually using eminent domain. Take your property. The state of Utah is Weber State. The state of Utah. The state of Utah. It's a state. State. They're using eminent domain to profiteer. So get this. So you remember the arches that used to come in here that were so cool and whatever? You know, I video them. Tore them down. Sold all this property to a private entity to build a hotel. You heard me right. So they took these people's property under eminent domain and sold it for massive, gigantic profit. Let's go play some Frisbee golf. It's disgusting. It's unbelievable. Well, it's so criminal. It's unbelievable. Oh, they're claiming that some law, it preempts their statute. I don't think there's a statute of limitations on the United States Constitution and the state of Utah's Constitution. Happy St. Patty's Day. In your head, zombies. So that's the greatest Irish song ever. Well, I love her, Dorothea. So, a cranberry sauce. That's Ben Lomond. Unite the clans, Scots. But it's unbelievable. It's unbelievable these derelicts are going to get away with this. It's so criminal. So where does the money go? Back to you. You know what? I mean, I used to be a student professor there. What professors make at Weber State tenured is sickening. Untenured don't make shit. The hierarchy, that goes to sports coaches. Taxpayers pay for those. It's Whittingham making $6 million a year. What? What? Get your, I mean, the Weber State bookstore is not even owned by the university. I'm not kidding you. So, this is so criminal. So the United States, well, that's the state of Utah right now. By the way, Governor Cox is the worst governor we ever had. You know, because I'm the anti-nuker. He's a pro-nuker. Who would have believed, you know, I'll tie this in. You know, because Governor Batt, Republican from Idaho, Cecil Andrews, I used to do so much work, Democrat from Idaho, were both fierce anti-nukers. They hard anti, they fought INL from hell like wolves pushing that nuclear waste out. Fighting. They both recently passed away. Well, he passed away in 2016, Cecil Andrews. You know, Batt just died this month. So now you have governors in Utah and governors, what about, you know, Scott Matheson and fierce anti. I mean, all these governors block nuclear waste coming in here. Tell Cox, not Cox gets in bed with Bill Gates, who stole the operating system from here. That's enough. We had a trial here in 2011. I was in the bone marrow transplant at LDS, or I'd have been there protesting. We had a trial here. Bill Gates stole the operating system from here. Word perfect, Novell. It's outrageous. And Cox signs an agreement with it, gets in bed to build little nuclear reactors in Kemmer, Wyoming. We're already funding SMRs in New Scale from Hell. Cox gets caught bringing in nuclear waste from Europe into southern Utah. My guess, he's probably been bringing it into Energy Solutions also. Nobody will report that. Kevin Blanch does. The truck that comes into the Promise Valley, the hot reactor from San Onofre, Look up the footage. My footage in the world, Kevin Blanche. Only person guarding the store out there, Kevin Blanche. But, you know, I've been a little busy. I mean, I'm in a 12-week rehab program. I had open heart surgery right there. Again, let's play two. Been fighting AML leukemia, fighting for my life. Seventh generation Utah, and they just... If you don't think Weber State's got issues, and I'm going to do a piece down there at the old gymnasium. March Madness. Who's the only guy from Ogden to ever win a national championship? Vern Garner? You mean the high school teacher at Bonneville? How about Watt Masaka, born and raised in Ogden, Utah? What, he won the national championship in the NCAA tournament? Yep, the only Utah team to ever do it. You know, Arnie Farron just passed away. He's from Ogden, but Watt went to Weber State. Watt was born and raised in Ogden. He won two national championships. He's of Japanese descent. You don't think they've got some racism issues going here? I'll guarantee you they do. Why won't they mention his name? Where's his number not in the banners? He wore number 77, by the way. 5'7" jump hook. I mean, I talked to so many. His relatives are all over this county. I always have been. J Street, 25th Street. I mean, it's where he grew up. Born and raised. I mean, he's such an American icon. He's such an Ogden, Utah icon. He's such a Weber State icon. But, okay, how about Thaw, McKay Brody? What? Yeah, she's Weber State. She's born and raised here in Weber County. What? So Weber State's got issues going against women. Weber State's got issues going against people of absolutely no doubt in my mind. You know, selling property. So take your house. I don't care if it was 40. I don't care about 100. I don't care if it's 226 years ago. The United States Constitution prohibits it. And they take these people's house and they sell it to build a private hotel. There's where your student fees are going, kiddies. And by the way, the parking Nazis here, someone's got to sue them. It's been going on for decades. They sell more parking passes than they have things. And then their greenwashing bus is their answer. They've been working on that greenwashing bus since 1999. They'll never. And by the way, electric buses, where do we get electricity from here in Utah, kids? Where do we get it, kids? What? Fossil fuels? Oh, yeah. Natural gas. So there's the answer, the greenwashing. By the way, concrete and asphalt are giant contributors to greenhouse emissions. So it's outrageous, you know, what they're doing. So they take these people's home under eminent domain. This is all part of the D Event Center. They used to have the big cool arcs. They tear them down and sell it off to a private entity to build it. Well, where does the money go? Look at these administrators and these. I mean, I taught at the number one school of business in the United States here, like a student professor. Number one, unarguable. Number one. We used to be Harvard Business School every single year. They wanted to go supply chain. We all fought. Clyde Cooley passed away. Kyle Madsen passed away. You know, I fought him. They don't even rank. They have made the Princeton Review, and that's the top 300 to be in the test. And they doubled their salaries, tripled their salaries, quadrupled their salaries. It's outrageous. So, Weber State, Puerto Rico, I mean, again, if you don't think they're racist against Asians, what? Masaka, just looking up. Just looking, one of the most iconic human beings in American history. Won the NCAA tournament. I didn't see nobody from University of Utah. Well, he won it. He won two national championships at JC at Weber State, the only ones they ever won. Don't mention his name. They sure threw Lillard's number up there in a hurry, though, didn't they? Oh, he sells a lot of merchandise. Watt was real quiet, calm. Damien's not. Damien's never won anything. He was ahead by 23 points in the second half in the Big Sky Championship game and lost. I don't see Phil Johnson's number up there either. They did get Kathy Miller's up there finally. She's from Ogden. So, sound the alarm. How about Fon McKay Brody? Watt Masaka. Kevin Blanche. They try to make a trifecta out of me. It's disgusting. Stay in tune.